I finished eventually the software for the cable. So this is the second video that we make about this cable. This is my software. This software is mostly used to identify problems. The whole logic will be inside the PCB. So here is the cable without the heatsink. These two are the same cables, but this has the heatsink covering the PCB. In this one, you can see the PCB. This cable also proved to not work properly, as it should. 55 amps of load. I don't care about power, I care about the amperes. Crafts are a little bit too small, but okay, I will fix that. I wanted the application to be as simple as possible. From here, I can select the OTP from 70 to 90. Degrees Celsius. I might set that higher. With 55 amps, temperatures are okay, but okay, we just started the load. And OCP, you can set it. Yeah, 5 is too low. You can see the alarm here. 5 is too low. Most likely I will have it from 10 to 16, 18, I will see. There's a buzzer. If something is wrong, the buzzer starts first, and after some period the protection kicks in. I think that the protection, it can be the same with the buzzer. That's not an issue. That's in seconds, the period. I will probably write that here. Temperature is rising. Check. Let's see. Everything's okay. If the cable is okay, temperatures are in control. But even if the temperatures are not in control, the PCB, this PCB here, will shut down the system. Yeah, 50 degrees, the highest, as it says there. This is it, guys. The cable works. I asked from CWT, Channel Y Technology, to make some changes. I want two all-one LED, green, okay, red, not okay. I want something better than the heatsink that they use, something more fancy, you know, but I don't want this to affect the final price. And I also asked for some more things. For example, a way to save the settings, because currently every time you shut down the PSU, the cable loses the settings that you set from the software. I want these settings from the software to be saved permanently on the PCB. Using a battery to retain these settings is a no-go for two reasons, because the PCB might get hot and the battery will break, or in the worst case scenario, explode. And secondly, shipping things with batteries create huge logistics problems. So we'll find a way to save the settings without using a battery, non-volatile memory or a capacitor. We will see about that, which is the easiest and more affordable way to do that. What you should know, that there is no need for this software to run, okay? There's no need for that. All logic is already in this PCB here. The software is only there if you want to do some debugging, if you want to check what is wrong, or if the cable works okay, as it should. So there is no need for the software. The software is just an extra bonus for those of you that you want to have a more complete picture of what is going on with the cable. That's all. See you next video.